Hello, thanks for joining us in another exciting episode of our Excel 2016 exam preparation series. If you've not watched episode 1 and 2, please do to go through our Facebook page at Fit Setipot, or you can go to YouTube and look for Former IT Training Services. You get the videos there and the links to the exercise files used in the video. So in this video, we will be looking at four key functions: how to use the find and replace, how to print headings across pages, the use of Countif formula, and how to modify an existing chart. So the exercise file we'll be using is the ice cream workbook. I will share the link in the caption of this video on Facebook for you to also download. So let's quickly look at a question. A shop you manage sells custom flavored ice cream. You are tracking the cost and profit of each flavor and summarizing the information in a workbook. So in task 1, we have to simultaneously replace all occurrences of the word choco with chocolate in the workbook. So how do you find and replace words? So assuming the choco appears about 5,000 times, are you going to change it manually? And that would be a waste of your time. So we go to our home tab, we locate the editing group. So on the editing group, I'll click on find and select. Then I'll click on replace. So what I'm seeking to achieve is to find choco and replace with chocolate. Then I'll click on replace all. So once I do that, automatically this task is accomplished. Then I move on to my next task in this project, which is asking us to go to our cost worksheet and repeat the rows containing the company logo and column headings so they appear on all printed pages. So what they want us to do is to make sure that row 1, 2 and 3 will appear on all the pages if we have about 5 or 10 pages in this particular worksheet. So to make it very simple and to make it more meaningful, since it's about appearing on all pages, we go to no other tab than the page layout tab. So I click on the page layout tab and I locate my page setup group. Within the page setup group, we have what print titles. You click on it, it opens up. Then you can repeat row 1, 2 and 3 at top. So with my page setup dialog box open with my sheet tab selected, I'll go to rows to repeat at top. So for the rows to repeat at top, I just can click and drag, then that is row 1 through to 3. Then I'll click on print preview to take a look if it's really worked. So I'll do that, and that is the result. So I'll go to page 2, then the rows I repeated at the top are still there. So you have over 5,000 pages, they will all come in that particular order. So it's very simple. If you don't know how to do this, then this is your first time of learning, then at least you've achieved something today. And this is also part of the Microsoft exam. So once you have the skill of passing the exam, it's very simple. So we move to task 3, and we are being asked to go to our profit worksheet and insert a formula that displays the number of sales greater than 250. So we have to go to cell B28 to do that particular task. So I'll go to my profit worksheet, then I'll need to locate B28. So if you're having a trouble or a challenge locating B28, you just go to your name box, you type B28, hit enter on the keyboard, and it will take you straight to that particular cell. if assuming we have about 5,000 rows, then you need to go through each of the rows to look for the cells that are greater than 250. If you do that, you are being inefficient and you can be sacked from your job, and that is not what we want. So it's a formula, so I have to go to my formulas tab, then I'll go to insert function. So once I click on insert function, I need to look for my county. So if it's not here in the list, then you can come and set county. But once it's here, I can click on it, click on the OK, or double click on it. You still get the same result. So this opens the function argument, and you need not to be scared. Many people are scared of Excel functions. It's not difficult. So the range gives you an idea of this count in the number of cells within a range that meet the given condition. So what range am I looking at? I'm looking at the sales range. So I'll click on it, control shift down arrow to select the entire range quickly. Then what criteria are we looking for? That is those greater than 250. That is sales greater than 250. So this will count the number of cells within a range that meets the given condition. So easy, it's not difficult learning Excel functions. So you click, then automatically you get your results before you even see it in the B28. I click on OK, then it pops up. So it's about 9 of them that's greater than 250. So if you don't know how to use the Countif formula, at least you've learned something from FIT today. Then the next task is to modify the chart on the profit worksheet. So the flavors are displayed as horizontal axis labels, and expense and income are the legend word series. So how do we go about this? So expense and income should rather be the legend series, and this should come as the labels, horizontal labels. So once you click on the chart, it opens a contextual tab. I'll go to design, and all I need to do is locate my data group and click on switch row or column. So once I do that, automatically it solves that particular task. And the next task is for me to modify the chart on the profit worksheet, so the legend appears at the top. So I'll go back to my worksheet, click on it, and I want the expense and income, which is our legend, to appear at the top. And it's about chart layout or chart element. So I'll go to my chart layout group. I come to add chart or element. So please do all, after practicing, try to explore the other options, because this is a self-study model. You can do it on your own and ace the exam. So we have the legend. I want it to appear at the top. So if it is to the left, the question demand, then you click on left. If it's to the right, you click on right. Yes, so thank you very much for the time. So that is just about it for our episode 2-3 of our Excel series. Please share on your wall and let your friends also, take